everyone, it's Sevi. So in my pulls for the Polar Star, I managed to snag a copy of the Akumaru. I decided to test it after my Polar Star comparison, and I found some very shocking but interesting results. For free-to-plays and low spenders, I want to emphasize my warning against pulling this weapon. Sniping is highly dangerous because you can get very, very unlucky. I think the only reason you should get this weapon is if you were wishing on the weapon banner to get Polar Star for your child, and it was a happy accident getting Akumaru. And if you didn't pull Polar Star but got this claymore in the process, I see that as a half win. So let's see what the Akumaru has to offer. First, let's examine its stats and effect at R1 and level 90. It has a low base attack of 510, which is offset by its attack percent second stat. If you compare it to something like a Wolf's Gravestone or the Unforged, the character's attack stat will be quite far off. The Claymore's strength comes from its passive effect, which is also what makes it fit for a burst DPS Claymore user. It says here that if you combine all your party's elemental burst cost, the equipped character's elemental burst damage will be increased by 0.12% for every point. So a team with 320 energy will give a 38.4% burst bonus, while a team with Raiden at 330 energy capacity will give 39.6%. So I wanted to find out for myself, how does it compete with other claymores? By the way, if you're new to my channel, I do a lot of testing videos with new weapons and characters, so if you're into that, please consider subscribing. My methodology is simple. I'll be trying this claymore on 4 characters, Yula, Beidou, Chongyun, and Diluc. These are claymore users who rely on their bursts to deal a good amount of damage. I'll be executing the same attack rotations and will compare the burst damage they can deal. I'll also place them in teams that are either popular combos or with optimal burst combined costs. Raiden will be taking the backseat for now. The Akumaru will compete with 5-star weapons, an R1 Song of Broken Pines and Wolf's Gravestone, all at level 90. Now before you say, wait a minute, isn't that unfair comparing it to 5-star weapons? I hear you, I thought it was too, but wait until you see the results. I'll throw in a bonus comparison to my Serpent Spine, which is currently at level 80 but at refinement 4. Since it doesn't give that much of a base attack boost from level 80 to 90, we can assume the difference won't be that far off, and we can just assume that it'll deal a bit more damage if it were at 90. We will have the Serpent Spine at full stacks to ensure maximum damage. However, normals and skilled damage receive no buff and will only be affected by the attack the weapon gives, which is relatively decent. While we'll compare burst damage, don't forget to take into account the skill and auto attack damage if you're using your character as an on-field main DPS too. With those in mind, let's begin. Let's start with our good boy Chongyun on the national team. I know that Akumaru wants higher energy and the national team doesn't max out the energy capacity, but let's still see how well it does in a team people often use Chongyun in. In this situation, Akumaru gives a 31.2% elemental burst damage to Chongyun. I do have to say that this is by far the best looking weapon on him, hands down. If only looks could kill, but it doesn't, so we'll have to see if it can with its damage. I'll compare Wolf's Gravestone and Akumaru. Here are his stats on each weapon, and he's currently using a full emblem set. The Wolf's Gravestone isn't at maximum damage since the added attack bonus won't proc unless the opponent is at 30% HP, but since that's very conditional, we can think about that another time. Let's look at their damage side by side. Now this is the first surprise. As you can see, the crit melt damage of Wolf's Gravestone is 30,369, and the normal crit is 19,448, while the Akumaru does 28,477 and 18,236. The Akumaru only did around 6% less damage than the Wolf's Gravestone. The fact that Akumaru at R1 is already competitive is very promising. Now let's switch over to Yula using a Pale Flame set, who will be comparing Akumaru against an R1 Song of Broken Pines, her clear best in slot. We'll do the exact same rotation to ensure that we get the same number of stacks and effects against the Geo Bishop. Let's see. The Akumaru dealt 226,607, while the Broken Pines dealt 256,898. That's around an 11.8% difference. Again, this is comparing a 4-star to a 5-star best in slot tailored to Yula. To have only that small a difference is already quite impressive. Now with Beidou, we're moving to the Cryoregispine and comparing Wolf's Gravestone and Akumaru with the Serpentspine at full stacks. She's using a full emblem set, and I'll also be using C6R to give her damage a buff. Additionally, on Serpentspine, I'll show my usual Beidou build with more optimized crit stats, since the advantage of Serpentspine is being able to build towards crit damage. So let's see the results. The crit hits are as follows: 14,856 for Wolf's Gravestone, 14,882 for Akumaru. This time, Akumaru is practically similar to Wolf's Gravestone. On Serpentspine, we have 15,264 for the optimized crit build. However, this can go higher if I max leveled my Serpentspine. But what's impressive is that Akumaru at R1 is comparable to an R4 Serpentspine. At this rate, Akumaru will be Beidou's new best in slot alongside Serpentspine, depending on how good your crit substats are. Lastly, we have Diluc's burst damage with teammates of 80 burst costs. First was Wolf's Gravestone. The crit damage is 59,558 for the initial burst and 6,764 for the smaller hits. Now, can you guess how much difference the Akumaru will have? It will have around a 5.9% difference, with 56,028 on the initial hit and 6,363 on the smaller hits. Not much, apparently. Of course, Diluc still gets a lot of damage from his skill damage, but regardless, Akumaru impresses once again. The conclusion is simple. At R1, and considering it's a 4-star, the Akumaru is surprisingly good for burst claymore users as long as you can assemble a team with relatively high burst costs. And if it's already that good at R1, imagine what it can do at higher refinements. Of course, keep in mind that its potential lies with the burst. If you look at the damage difference with normal attacks and skill damage, of course other weapons whose effects are not limited to the burst damage will have a significant advantage. But that's really the only issue I have. Other than that, I would say that while Akumaru may be too risky trying to pull, if you actually do manage to get one, I can highly recommend building this weapon even at R1. It's extremely versatile and competitive, and best of all, it's incredibly stylish. So that's going to be all for this video. Thank you so much for watching. If this helped you out, please consider subscribing to my channel, leave a like, and leave a comment below if you got the Akumaru, and if you did, who you would use it on. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon. Take care!